Let us discuss an important concept for issue of magnetic moment of a rotating charge body to its angular momentum. Let's start with the concept with a point charge plus Q. Say a point charge plus Q is circulating in a circle of radius R with an angular speed omega. If it is rotating very fast, we can directly say its equivalent current can be given as Q omega by 2 pi, which we already discussed in previous sections. And this can be written as equivalent average current because the charge is not present everywhere. So it is continuously rotating and producing a current which is equal to this. Corresponding to this current, if we calculate the magnetic moment of this rotating charge, this magnetic moment can be given as M as I pi r square, current multiplied by the enclosed area. So on substituting the value of current, it will be half Q omega r square. And here if we calculate the angular momentum of this revolving charge, then angular momentum we can also consider it is given that of mass m, then the angular momentum L can be written as mr square omega, which you already studied in the section of rotation of rigid bodies. And if we find out the ratio of this magnetic moment and angular momentum, this m by L, you can see what we are getting. It is half q omega r square divided by mr square omega. Here omega r square gets cancelled out and the result we are getting is q by 2m. This is the concept which you need to keep in mind for all uniformly charged bodies or for a point charge. Always the ratio of magnetic moment to angular momentum comes out to be a constant, which is the charge to mass ratio multiplied by 1 by 2. This will always remain constant, this q by 2m you should always keep in mind. And this factor itself has a physical significance when we talk about the revolution of electrons and different atoms. At microscopic level, some magnetic properties are defined based on this factor, which is termed as different kind of magnetons. So we'll discuss separately about it in the section of modern physics, but right now you need to keep in mind that the ratio of magnetic moment to the angular momentum is always a constant, which is q by 2m. In continuation, let's discuss about a uniformly charged rod AB, which is positively charged with a charge q and it is of length L, and about an A if it is rotating at an angular speed omega. And for this system, if we wish to find out the ratio of magnetic moment to the angular momentum, we can find out angular momentum directly. Here we can write angular momentum of rod is, this can be written as I omega, and for a rod if it is of mass m, about one end if it rotates, then its angular momentum can be written as 1 by 3 ml square multiplied by omega. This is the moment of inertia, 1 by 3 ml square multiplied by omega. This we are having. Say this is our equation 1. And to find its magnetic moment, we consider an element of width dx at a distance x from end A about which the rod is rotating. Then this element dx will be circulating with the same angular speed in a circle of radius x. So here we can find out equivalent current for circulation of element dx is, this can be written as dI, and its charge dq can be written as q by L dx because the charge q is uniformly distributed on length L. So this can be written as dq omega by 2 pi. So equivalent current here is q omega by 2 pi L dx. And the magnetic moment of the element is this magnetic moment dm, we can write as its current ti multiplied by the area enclosed, which is pi x square. So here we can find our total magnetic moment of a rotating rod is m, we can write integration of dm, which is integration of di, we can write as q omega by 2 pi l multiplied by pi x square dx, and it will be integrated within limits from 0 to l as x varies from a to b. Now in this situation, the value of m here, we can see pi gets cancelled out, so this will be q omega by 2 l. And when x square is integrated, it will be x cube by 3, which is integrated within limits from 0 to L. So here we are getting 1 by 6 q omega by L multiplied by L cube. Here again L gets cancelled out. So m we are getting is 1 by 6 q omega L square. So this is our equation 2. And again, if we wish to find out from equation 1 and 2, if we calculate magnetic moment to the angular momentum ratio, on substituting here, you can see we are getting 1 by 6 q omega L square divided by 1 by 3 m L square omega. Here, omega L square gets cancelled out, this 3 also gets cancelled out, and the result we are getting q by 2 m, which we already defined earlier. So all students should keep in mind that for uniformly charged rotating bodies, always the ratio of their magnetic moment to angular momentum will be q by 2m, and always remember it is valid for uniformly dense, symmetric and uniformly charged bodies. It is not like for a random shaped object, you charge it in any way and then rotating, the ratio will remain constant. It will not happen always.